I forget what he said. I think he's going to be over on the other coast coming in or something. And he said, don't tell what he want from me. And I said, well, you know a lot of people, you got a lot of posts. Maybe you could tell me where he's coming in. He said, hell no, soldier, I can't tell you. I couldn't find that out. And he walked off, and then he came back and he said, you come in here all the time for coffee? And I said, no. He said, could you come in tomorrow night? And I said, I think so. He says, well, come in tomorrow night and have a cup of coffee. So the next night I go in, pretty soon he walks by and he said, you ever heard of so-and-so? And he named town. And I said, no. He said, it is the prettiest town you ever saw. If you get a chance, you ought to go. And he turned around and walked off. So I said, that's where Wilbur is, I guess. So I go back to my captain and I said, I'd like a few days off. And he said, who are you kidding? You know, we haven't given a pass. We can't get a pass. And I said, my brother just came in. I think I know where, and I'd like to go see him. I said, we're not busy now, are we? And he says, no. He said, where is he at? And I said, on the other side of France. He said, how are you going to get there? And I said, well, I'll take my motorcycle. He says, that won't work. He said, you get a couple hundred miles, you get 100 miles back here, probably 50 miles. And they said, the MPs will all pick you up. You can't ride that bike anywhere you want. As long as you're up here around the front, nobody cares what you do. No, he said, I can't tell you you can take that bike. He said, I might get in trouble. So I said, well, I'd still like the time off. I said, I'll hitchhike if I have to. And he said, well, I can't give a pass, but I'll tell you what. You have had a lot of 24 hours, and you haven't got in trouble, so I'm going to give you a little extra break, you know. And he said, I'll give you a 24-hour pass for tomorrow, and I'll make a separate 24-hour pass for the next day. And then I want you back here the following day. I said, that's not much time. And he said, I know it. He said, that's the best I can do, and put it on paper and it's legal. I said, okay, I'll take it. And I said, you know I'm liable to be late. But I said, I also know you, as long as you stay out of trouble, you don't break anybody for being late. But a lot of guys get 24-hour pass, they're out and drunk and getting fights, and they end up losing their rank and everything else. But I was careful. I never yeah. got in trouble, you know. So he gave me the 24-hour passes, and I got up the next morning, and it was a long walk to a paved road, and I started hitchhiking. And I was just really lucky later that day. I ran into a French airman in a truck, two fellas. And they stopped and told me to jump in. We couldn't speak, you know. But we went all day, we went the rest of the day, and I realized he'd asked me, where am I going to stay tonight? You know, and I told him, I don't know. So he let me bleed. He said, come on with him. That's what he wanted. Just stay with me and I'll find you a place to stay. I thought I understood it all right, and it was right. We went to his field where he was flying from. He even got me something to eat and got me a cot. and then said goodbye. He said in the morning, he said, you could just leave anytime you want. No one else say anything. I don't remember if I got breakfast or not. But that